Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I am back with a brand new video and this is going to be my March favorites video. I did not have a favorites video last month just because products didn't really stand out to me and I honestly couldn't remember any that I was like I need in my life and I need to tell you guys about. But this time I have quite a few, so we're gonna get right into this video. But before I do, please do not forget to subscribe to this channel if you are brand new. And if you're already subscribed, hit that notification bell so you know when I do upload another video. And thank you so much for joining me again today. As always, I will link all of the products down below in the description box as well as what is on my face right now. And please comment down below to let me know you stopped by before you leave and let's get right into it. I'm gonna start off with brushes. I have been loving trying out new brushes, but there is a collection from Morphe that I'm just in love with, and that is the Elite Collection. Girl, I'm telling you right now, if you haven't tried the Elite Collection or you were contemplating picking it up, definitely get it because they are bomb.com. So I'm gonna start with this brush right over here. Unfortunately, the number has rubbed off, but I will link everything down below. This is an angled flat top kabuki brush, and I love this brush to apply liquid foundation on my face. It is so good. Doesn't leave my foundation streaky or anything like that. It literally leaves my foundation like airbrush looking. It blends it out so beautifully. It's nice and dense, but still soft on the skin and just overall an amazing brush. You can also use this for concealer because it has like that angled finish to it or shape to it. It gets right under the eyes and just does an amazing job in blending out liquid products. I love this. And then the other brush from the collection is the E41. Look at this baby. Okay, I have a thing for large powder brushes, and this is so beautiful, so luxurious. It's super soft on the face. I just love this to put some powder on the center of my face and set my concealer. It just does the trick for me. Picks up enough product and blends it out nicely. Overall, I think I just love the way it looks. I'm really into like the way products look, and this is just, it's gorgeous. I love it. Now we're gonna go on to some lashes that I've been loving. I'm really into lashes now, especially for like Instagram pictures. I find that they just complete the look and pull everything together. They bring so much attention to the eye. So I've been trying my best to wear lashes for my Instagram pictures. And these are the ones that I've been loving. So the first brand that I'm going to talk about is Lady Lashes. I think I've mentioned them before. This is a Canadian owned brand and they are from Toronto. And girl, if you want some lashes that are affordable, because I don't find that they are super expensive, but have a beautiful finish to them, they last long, Lady Lashes. I mean, customer service is awesome and the product is amazing. Packaging is on point. This particular one is called Bella Donna and it is just beautiful, flary lashes that I am in love with. I'll give you guys a close-up of this one. There is Bella Donna. I love, love how separated they are and they just bring a lot of attention to the eyes. These are more romantic, I find, so really, really pretty, and they fit my eyes really nicely, and I find that they are very light that I forget that I'm wearing lashes. Sometimes when you wear lashes, like the ones that I'm wearing right now are Huda Beauty and I can feel them. Like they feel a little bit heavy and you can kind of see a shadow there. With these ones, I don't. They fit nicely and they stay in place. The next lashes that I'm going to talk about are from Velour Lashes. This is another brand that I absolutely love. These lashes are luxurious. I mean, I've only gotten like 3 pairs and I can't get enough of them. This particular style is called Mama Knows Best and it's a little bit more natural than the other ones that I have, but I love them also. Here is Mama Knows Best. My ring light might be like, you know, too bright for it, but I hope you guys can see that. But I love these lashes. I love how they go from light to thicker on the outer half. They give you that nice cat eye effect because of that. They're so wispy, and best thing of all, they are super, super light on the eyes. You really don't feel these ones at all. And for both of them, I'm going to say the application process is really easy. The lash band is not too thick in my opinion. This is My Burberry Black and I love this scent. First of all, the packaging is super beautiful, very high-end and classy. I love the little black bow right here. And the scent is like, it's very seductive. It's sweet, but a little bit musky in my opinion. And it's just like, oh, it's so unique. I love, love this scent. I do have the original My Burberry, which is a little bit more fresh. This one is just a bit more like a woman, you know, it's a little bit more adult-like. And I love this fragrance so much because again, it lasts really long on myself and on my clothes. And just like, it just, everyone can smell it. It's all over the place when I put it on. I love this one. This is the Urban Decay Quick Fix Hydro Charged Complexion Prep Priming Spray right over here. And I've been loving this one because it hydrates my skin so well. It has a coconut scent to it and it does have coconut water in it. So it's going to be very, very well for the skin. It leaves my skin feeling really supple and allows all my other products to glide onto the skin. So I have been loving this so much. And then the next spray that I want to talk about is from Marc Jacobs and it's called, this is their new Recover Perfecting Coconut Setting Mist right here. I do have a hate and love relationship with this one because I hate the way it sprays. The nozzle on this thing is just the worst thing ever. I don't know what they were thinking if they didn't try it out, because when you spray this on your face, you will get a lot of oil spots and you have to blend it out with your beauty blender right away or you will see it all over the face over your makeup. And girl, trying to fix that is going to be a nightmare. But I love the way it refreshes my skin. It gives me a beautiful glow. And I love the scent of it. Again, this one, it has a strong coconut scent. And I love the packaging. You get a good amount of product. But the nozzle is a no-go. Like, I wish they'd fix this because you spray it and it's like, it's not even that it's harsh. And it does go everywhere, but it leaves a lot of little dots on the face, but it just, it smells amazing. It feels amazing on the skin. So I still love it and use it almost every time I do my makeup. The only thing that I do is right after I spray it, I go ahead and dab my beauty blender all over the face just to take away any like oil spots or anything like that. But I have lip products to show you guys that I have been completely obsessed with and wearing nonstop. So I have liquid lipsticks and these are from Girlactic. Not the specific colors, but the formula on the these are some of the best liquid lipsticks on the market. I'm telling you guys, if you have never heard of Girlactic or even tried them out, you want a liquid lipstick that's going to be long lasting but not dry out your lips, these are the ones to go. They are so comfortable, so creamy, and extremely opaque on the lips. Like, I'm telling you, one swipe is like full color payoff. I absolutely love it. It has like a nice, thick, creamy texture to it, so it smooths out your lips and doesn't emphasize on any fine lines. Stunning. Okay, so the color that I have been loving a lot is Playful, and this is a nice brown tone shade. Right over here, they smell really nice too. They have a nice sweet scent to them. It's just like, it's so creamy. And look at this, look at the color payoff. Like, this is crazy. And then another one that I like is Divine. And I'm gonna put Divine right over here. And this is more of a mauve-y shade right there. Has more pinks to it than this one, of course. And I've just been loving them because they dry really nicely on the lips, really comfortable. They actually make your lips look nice and plump and healthy. They don't like suck all the moisture off of your lips. So I've just been loving the Girlactic liquid lipsticks. I don't own all of them, but I definitely want to pick up more because they are some of the best formulas out there. Another lip product that I've been loving is from Makeup Forever, and this is their Artist Acrylip kind of liquid lipsticks. And these guys are really, really, really nice. Super different, in my opinion, out there in the market. They have kind of like a thin consistency. This color in particular is called 300, and it is a vibrant orange shade right there. They have a little bit of a creamy consistency, but when you put them on the lips, you have enough time to blend them out. But they are super glossy and comfortable on the lips. I love them. I do have to wear a lip liner with it so it doesn't bleed out. But other than that, the colors are so vibrant and so glossy. If you love like a glossy lip and you want that color payoff, these are the ones to go. Another thing that I love about them is that they blend really well. Like I can mix different shades together to customize or to create like lip art. These blend out really well in my opinion, and they're just so comfortable on the lips and extremely, extremely long lasting in my opinion. Even though they have like a glossy look to them, they really do last long. Even when you're eating, I have had lunch with it and I find that the lip product is still intact. So super impressed with them, and I will have a lip swatch video on the colors that I own very, very soon. This is the Pixi Beauty Strobe and Bronze Palette. It is called the Glow and Bronze Palette, and it looks like this. I haven't used any of the highlighting shades yet, but the bronzing shades are my favorite. I absolutely love them because they contour my cheeks so well, but they also bronze at the same time. So I use these two shades all of the time. Like literally ever since I got sent to me, thank you so much to Pixi Beauty. These are the two shades that I have been using to bronze and contour the cheeks. I normally use this shade right here to bronze and then this one to contour, or either or. I don't even remember which way I do it, but they are like perfect shade. Very, very pigmented. Okay, so I was super surprised. I've never used Pixi before. This was the first time, and they have really great products. They are now sold at Shoppers Drug Mart if you are in Canada. I have seen them all over the place, so get your hands on this one if you're looking for a nice contouring shade. This is amazing. So now I have three highlighters to show you guys because I am completely obsessed with highlighting, and I feel like there's a highlighter coming out every single week of my life, and I feel like I need them all in my life, even though they all look very, very similar. But these three have blown me away, okay? I'm gonna start off with the one that I have. Hello? Hello, what is this? It's so good. This is a $5 highlighter right over here. It is from Wet n Wild, and it is called Precious Petals. Girl, it's so hard to find in Canada, but a lot of people told me they have found it at Rexall. So go over there. If you find it, get two or three because you are going to be completely in love and blown away. This is a beautiful champagne shade. Oh my gosh, it is so intense. So intense. I absolutely love it. It's so creamy and buttery. It doesn't pick up on any texture. It literally just highlights the face so well. And it is like, if you love your intense highlights, this is intense. This is intense and creamy and beautiful. Blends out amazingly. I love it. Okay. The next highlighter is from Estee Lauder right here. It is an oldie, but they released it again because it was limited edition. I think it's still limited edition. This is called Heat Wave. Love the packaging. Love the pattern. Oh, but the highlight though, it is a white gold shade, like a light gold shade. Can you guys see that? I don't know. Oh, right there. Come on, Estee. Come on, Estee. This is gorgeous. This is like beautiful, bronzy, gold shade. So intense. This one does have a little bit of glitter particles in it. So you kind of want to be careful where you're placing it so it doesn't pick up on texture. But it's just like beautifully done. It's tasteful, the glitter particles. It is gorgeous. In the inner corners of the eyes, kill it. kill it, okay? So the last palette that we are going to talk about is from Anastasia Beverly Hills in collaboration with Nicole Guerrero. This palette is completely hyped up on Instagram and YouTube, and for all of the right reasons. Those that are saying they don't like it, girl, I don't know how you don't like this. This palette is everything. It's super intense, super blinding, very, very pigmented. So if you don't like extremely pigmented highlighters, you probably will get turned off by this one. But I love it because I can make it lighter just by, you know, picking up less product and using a different brush. It is so beautiful. The colors that she created are stunning, and some of them are different, and I love that they suit a lot of skin tones. Like, she really thought this out, like the darker shades over here, the really light shade, and you can layer them to customize them. This palette is that is it for my favorites video. I hope you enjoyed and saw some products you might want to pick up and try. Definitely comment down below and let me know, what are you loving right now? What are your favorite products? For me, the highlighters, I'm shook. I mean, girl, $5. I'm so impressed with Wet n Wild. And yeah, thank you so much for joining me again today. Please do not forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Share this video, and I will see you all on the next one. Ciao!